Chapter 2 is almost accomplished. However, one particular aspect in the context of Bravais lattices and crystal systems still needs some explanations. And that is the relationship between the trigonal crystal system, the rhombohedral lattice, and the hexagonal lattice in its R centering. So, let's start. The trigonal crystal system is one of the seven crystal systems. It is characterized by its threefold rotational symmetry. But, interestingly, in a way, there are two kinds of crystals belonging to this trigonal crystal system. If we were forced to represent all crystals of the trigonal crystal system with a primitive unit cell or a primitive lattice, we would need two different ones. Firstly, a primitive rhombohedral unit cell and the respective rhombohedral lattice, and secondly, a primitive cell which is absolutely identical with a primitive hexagonal unit cell or lattice. The rhombohedral cell is new to us. So, what is a rhombohedron and what is a rhombohedral lattice? The metric of a rhombohedral unit cell is specified as follows. We have the lattice constants A equals B equals C. It reminds us of the cubic crystal system. However, the angles are also identical to but unequal to 90 degrees. So a rhombohedral unit cell looks like this. We have here the lattice vectors A, B and C. The angles between the vectors are all the same, but not 90 degrees. And the threefold axis of rotation runs in this direction along the body diagonal. A rhombohedron can be derived from a cube, which is a special case of a rhombohedron in which the angles are indeed 90 degrees. If we stand a cube on one of its corners in this way, and if we now compress or stretch this cube along this diagonal, then we get a rhombohedron. A rhombohedron is of course a parallelepiped, and it is of course completely space-filling if you assemble them together face by face, as you can see here in this small animation. However, there's one problem with such a rhombohedron, and this is the fact that any of these three axes, any of the lattice vectors, are not identical with the direction of its threefold axis of rotation, which is the body diagonal. The problem is that, let me say, crystallographers are a bit inflexible. They like strict rules. And there is the rule that the axis of rotation with the highest order should run parallel to the c-axis. And this can be accomplished also for the rhombohedral lattice, if we transform it into the following way. If we take this diagonal as the new c-direction, marked here as c', then the lattice points of the rhombohedron have the following fractional coordinates along this c' direction. 0 and 1 for the red points, 1/3 for the green ones, and 2/3 for the blue ones. The green and blue ones are transformed into each other by this threefold axis of rotation. We keep this in mind for a while. So, next step, the projection along c', meaning if we look from above onto this rhombohedron, looks like this. With the new axes a' and b' along these directions. And now we apply the translational principle of unit cells by translating this pattern in the plane a' and b' by whole units. And then we get something like this. And now the question is, are we able to choose a larger unit cell which has the metric of one of the other crystal systems? Think for a while. Look at the red lattice points. Yes, The red lattice points are the basis for a new unit cell. Let's have a more detailed view on this new cell. This new cell has indeed the metric of the hexagonal crystal system. A equals B, C is not specified, and the angles are alpha equals beta equals 90 degrees, and gamma is 120 degrees. Unlike in the hexagonal primitive cell, it is a centered cell with two additional lattice points inside the cell, one at C prime equals 1/3 and the other along C prime at 2/3. Now, in our new centered cell, the axis of rotation with the highest order is running indeed along the C axis, according to the rule. Perfect! Okay, and here is a scheme in which both unit cells are shown so that you can see how these cells are connected by each other. The original rhombohedral cell and the new rhombohedral centered cell with a hexagonal metric. We have additional lattice points at the fractional coordinates 1/3, 2/3, 2/3, and 2/3, 1/3, 1/3. Now, as we have this hexagonal metric, does this also mean that we have a six-fold axis of rotation? Perhaps here at the corner of the unit cell? Let's have a look. We rotate the unit cell by 60 degrees stepwise, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, and end up with this pattern. Obviously, this rotation by 60 degrees is not a symmetry operation. The red lattice points are congruent, but the green one lies above the blue one and the blue one lies above the green one in the neighboring cell, but the green and the blue lattice points have different heights along the C direction. Of course, we cannot change the symmetry of a lattice regardless of what kind of centering we choose. The symmetry is an intrinsic property of the lattice. And this means finally that we only have, logically, a threefold axis of rotation as illustrated here. Okay, that was not so easy and we hope you are still involved. Let us shortly conclude. All crystals of the trigonal crystal system can be represented in a lattice with a hexagonal metric. This is also valid for those crystals of the trigonal crystal system that have a rhombohedral lattice when they are represented in its primitive form. But it is always possible to transform the primitive rhombohedral cell into the R-centered cell with hexagonal metric. And that is the reason why there is indeed such a thing like a rhombohedral lattice, but not something like a rhombohedral crystal system. And the advantage of transforming the rhombohedral cell into its hexagonal R-centered counterpart is that the threefold axis of rotation is then running along one of the lattice vectors, namely the C direction. And this is consistent with crystallographic conventions.